Hey, what's going on, y'all? Okay, so today we are doing a lure review. I had a company called Odds Pro, and they wanted me to test some of their swim baits out. I haven't even looked at them yet. I've looked at them online. The colors look really good on them. So I'm going to give my honest opinion after testing it out, of course. But trying not to step. Look, it's like so much goose crap over here. The water is looking as good as I wanted it to, so I'm excited about that. And this is the first spot I wanted to come to, because if I can catch a fish in here, see, they're popping out there. If I can catch a fish in here on that little swim bait, then pretty much go anywhere and catch a fish on it. All right, y'all, so my only complaint so far, and this could have been, I don't think it's the company, I think it's Amazon. They sent this little package in a box that was about this big. I mean, that's really wasteful. I'm sure that was an Amazon thing, but I'm not gonna point any fingers. All right, well, that's coming off the way that I would expect it to. Try it like this, maybe. Oh, okay. They're individually wrapped inside of the... Oh, wow. Well, they look nice. Alright, well, I found the one that we're starting with. Check this out. Got the purple on it. Looks kind of bassy. It's kind of bluegillish. Okay, so they do... Okay, so look in... They do the cloth fiber in between. That's gonna look really good. It's kind of like a trout pattern, but that's what I'm starting with. Nice and straight, everything's symmetrical. For someone with OCD like me, that's a good thing. Okay, so let's go ahead and get rigged up and we'll start testing it. So here we go. First impression. I like it. I actually do like it. I like it a lot. I like the size of it. I thought it was gonna be bigger than that. It's a 4-pack, but I honestly thought that they were going to be like 2 inches longer than that, but I'm not. I like the size. I think it's going to swim really well. The only thing I'm worried about is the way that it was shipped. See how this is straight right here? And then you get down to the tail and look. I don't know if you can bend that around. Oh. Oh, okay. There. Okay, cool. Alright, so yeah, I'm not worried about that anymore. Anyway, I think it's going to look really good. I like the fact that it's got a lip. I don't remember seeing that on the little picture. This company asked me to review this for them. They actually sent them to me for free. So it's not like I was going to be like, no, I don't think that's going to work. I don't know how fast this thing is going to sink. Should probably test that first. Oh, it actually doesn't sink too fast. Oh, that looks sick in the water. I'll get some underwater footage of this for you. That looks so good in the water. Give it a test. I think I'm going to keep it, since it's so weedy right here, kind of keep it up a little bit until I get the hang of it. That's what I like about using new lures is... I already got into the weeds. I wonder if it probably dives down. No, you can keep it towards the top. Alright. Let's see if we can toss it out there. Okay, well. Let's see if we can keep it up towards the top. Is that possible? Yeah? It is possible. Alright, so one thing that's already happening is that back treble is getting caught around the tail. Look, I just did it again and all I was doing was moving it a little bit. That back treble is getting caught around the tail. Which that could be fixed. Alright, I got bored walking over here. Yeah, so first impression, I think what they could have done was they could have moved, which I could do, move that treble right here up to right to that segment right there. I don't think it would affect the action of it. It's a little deeper in here. If you recall, is that a gator? If you recall, the last time that we were here, there's one. There are a bunch of little bass in here. Oh, he ate that thing. Bunch of little, oh, that's nice. Sorry, buddy. They always make it back to the water, don't they? Bunch of little bass in here. And, yeah. So, they apparently are digging this lure. I caught a bunch on the drop shot last time we were here. Any hanging off of that bush over there? What is? Oh, that's actually a healthier looking one. Still tiny, but oh, sorry, buddy. You gotta stop, and I'll get that out of you. Stop. This one out of your side first. And then get it at your grill. Little guy. It's a hungry little guy. There you go, bud. Thanks for playing the game. Two bass, chase it. Get away from the turtle's butt. There's two turtles chasing that thing. Watch. What are you doing? There's one. Yeah, you got it, buddy. It's a little healthier. Now you're gonna start going? It's like he didn't know what to do. Another little one. Well, it'll catch fish. I wanted to come to a spot where there were actually feeding fish to see if it would actually work. It does work. It's got a nice hook set. So, I mean the positioning of that back treble, look, it just flipped back around already. The positioning of that back, I don't care too much for, but it does have nice action to it. That's my only complaint about it so far. It'd be cool if they made a floating version. Of course, I can put some of those suspend dots on top of this and it would suspend just fine. Or, you know what I mean. It would float. I could put enough of them on to make it float and use it like a wake bait. That'd be pretty cool. Yeah, that's as big as you are, bass. There's a bass that's like maybe half an inch longer than the lure, trying to eat the lure. How's that gonna work? It's like, hey brother, I'm gonna eat you. Alright, well, it's time to go to the other spot. Overstayed our welcome here. It's overcast today, so let's go a little bit flashy. All right, well, first complaint, there's something wrong with this one. Even if you, if the hooks are right on it, it's not swimming right. It just wants to keep twirling. All right, well, that one's no good. That stinks. So on to the, I don't know, kind of like a red-breasted sunfish kind of color. Anyway, let's try it. That's a shame. I like that fire tiger color too. I've caught lots of fish on the Rapala fire tiger color. This one is working the way that it's supposed to. Yay. All right, y'all. On to one more spot. Haven't got to put this thing to the big bass test yet. Let's hit it again. Foot is on fire from those bites from the fire ants. They went right in the holes of my Crocs. All right, y'all, last stop because unfortunately I cannot fish all day. Let's see if we can't get a 3-pounder or maybe a 4-pounder to obliterate this thing. From the gator. It's a better fish. Oop. Stop. Alright, still got lots of fight left in you. Hope this one's been sitting in the weeds. And now you got your other. Right. Tell you what, let's get that hook out. I got one hook out. Got another hook in you. There he goes. And here comes the gator. Right on the edge of the weeds. Getting that right depth and then getting it to the right point in the weeds and then working it up that edge, and they're coming up and hitting it right about there. There's one. That's a better one. Bass right there. There she goes. And here comes the little gator there. And I don't see the other one. There are two smaller gators in here. That was a better fish. They're getting bigger. They are getting bigger. I'm excited. Oh, that is a dark bass right there. It's a dark one. Look at that. Been hiding in the weeds. Fortunately, my gator friend is trying to eat a goose right now. All right, y'all. It wouldn't be a true lure review unless I reviewed every single one of them. So let's try this one out. This is the last color in there. I guess it's kind of like a, baby bass. It's probably supposed to be a trout, but it looks kind of like a baby bass a little bit. I don't know. We'll see. We're just going to try it. Give it the old, what just be like, well, so far it's swimming the way it's supposed to. Oh, never mind. False. False. It's swimming sideways. That's it. After using these for a few hours, I really like them. I wish this one swam better, and I wish this one swam better. I think I'm going to try to tweak them, see what's wrong with them, and it is hot out here. Sorry. Anyway, the that one, the rainbow trout color, and the red-breasted sunfish one, those ones did the best out of all four. Two out of four is not great for how true they run, but like I said, I think I can tweak them, but right out of a pack, that's not something you really want to do is tweak your lures. But I'm gonna give them a go again. I think, I caught tons of bass off of them. Well, not tons, but caught quite a few bass off of them. But overall, I would give them probably, I'll tell you what, let's do this fairly. Let's just do, I know there are four in the pack, but let's base the review off of the two that actually worked. I would give it probably a 10 out of a 10. There are like multiple ways you can fish them too. So I took that into account for the review. You can swim them straight in. You can, well, not this one, but you can swim them straight in. So you can pretty much work them any depth you want because they sink. So I would say probably about maybe a foot every 1.5 seconds, if I had to guess. So if you count down, just throw in Mississippis, then you should know where you're at as far as feet. Twitching action on them, working them like a jerkbait, that was what was most effective, and then keeping them towards the top, which is all done with the your rod. So if you keep your rod tip up like this and just twitch like that, then you're able to sort of get that action like this, but towards the top. And then what I was doing was throwing out past these weeds and into the deeper water, bringing it back, and then just twitching it up the side of the weeds opposite from me, and then they were coming up and hitting it right on the side of the weeds. So they were kind of on that weed edge, just sitting there waiting for prey to come by so they could ambush it. But really effective. The rattles are nice. It kind of reminds me of like a rattle trap. It's got like little tiny BBs you can hear. That was nice. I really like the bill. It gave it a lot of action. Trebles seem to be pretty good. The hookup ratio is really good on it. I like the segments. I'm a fan of whatever it is, that cloth or polyurethane segmented lure style that they do. I really like. That makes it, really, really lifelike. But yeah, good lure. I liked it. Definitely something that I would spend $20 on. I'll have to look and see if Odds Pro has more swim baits in different colors. But check them out, Odds Pro swim baits. You can get the 4-pack of them for this side at $20. That's shipping and everything. But I will catch you all next time. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you liked the video, comment down below. Tell me you liked it. Hit that thumbs up button to show me you liked it. Make sure you share the video out and make sure you subscribe. I'll catch you all next time. Take care.